Hello, my name is David Lee. I'm a middle blocker for the USA men's national team, gold medalist from 2008 Beijing Olympics, and I'm going to give you a brief instruction on blocking the volleyball.
In the semifinals of Beijing Olympics in 2008, the Americans defeated Russian national team. David scored last point in that game. He blocked Max Mikhail, thus confirming the reputation of one of the best middle blockers in the world.
It's a pretty simple skill. The idea is to stop your opponent from attacking the ball over the net, and then you have to block the ball. Basically, the idea is to get your hands pressed over the net as far as possible and back into the court. I'll show you a few moves. If I'm going to block a middle blocker that's coming at me, I'm going to load my legs, jump, and press over the net. The idea is to get the hands over the net for as long as possible. If I'm blocking someone coming from position four, I'm going to make a move called a three-step crossover, where I go start with my right foot leading. I'm going to go right, left, right, come here, jump, and over. And when I'm blocking here, I want to have my hands pushed back into position six or back into the middle of the court. If my hands are facing this way, the chances are that the ball is going to go out of bounds. If they're facing this way, it's going to go back into the court for a kill, hopefully. A lot of blocking comes down to, it's called read blocking, where it's set up by you reading the setter and being able to time, say the setter is going to set to position four, I have to make the read and go that direction. After that's done, the rest of it's pretty simple. It goes to the footwork again, left, right, left, right, left, right, or if you're jumping with the middle to commit. But the game is called read blocking for a reason, and that is you must read the situation and then react to it. It's the exact same move going to the left, but with different footwork. So I'm going to go left, right, left, plant, up, over. Same thing, hands pressed back into the court so the ball goes back that way.
Jump is an important part of the game on the block. The height of jump is an important but not the main component.
It does help if you jump higher with blocking, but the main importance to the jump is the timing of the jump. So it must be timed when the hitter is going to attack the ball. So when the hitter is jumping, I must in turn jump with him and then time when he's going to attack. But to your question is how do you jump higher? That's going to take many years of plyometric training. We'd have to go into the gym if you want to see that. Quick demonstration of the front squat. Which will in turn help for quad tendonitis and patellar tendonitis. It's important that you go down very slow.
Like all professional athletes, volleyball players are also injured. And if the broken fingers are not so serious injuries, the injuries of the knee can take the player out of the game for a long time.
I think anytime you're taking multiple jumps, there's going to be chronic damage done to tendons and cartilage. And that's especially true for volleyball players. But I think as long as you have a good strength program and there's enough rest in between your trainings, then you can basically play pain-free. It's one of my favorites, especially when I'm having a lot of pain, because my problem is chronic quad tendonitis, which is something most volleyball players deal with. Other than that, blocking is pretty simple. It's a skill that's not easy to do, but if done correctly, there's a lot of real points that can be made, and it can increase your chance of victory.